guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing. In today's video guys, we're going to go ahead and show you how to remove and replace water pump on Hyundai Elantra guys generation 2011 to 2016-17. We'll have more than 200 videos taking this whole car apart guys. That's right, more than 200 videos will be made on the channel. So please subscribe. If you need anything, drop a comment below the video, and you can find more information and tools and parts that we use in the description of the video below. Also, if you want to find some electrical videos about that car, engine codes, airbag codes will be listed on this brand new channel that we just made guys, so please give a subscribe as well. Now this is a 2013 Elantra, but it will cover the whole generation with a 1.8 engine. The first step is you have to drain the coolant, so stay with us. We'll show you how to drain the coolant. This is because when you remove the water pump, you have to have no coolant in the engine, otherwise you leak everything out. Even though we'll drain the coolant, we'll still have some in the engine block, but that's fine. So let's go ahead and proceed now. So you need to do very minimal disassembly. Stay with us. We removed the air filter box, but you do not have to do that. We removed it so I can shoot with the camera and show you where the drain plug is. Otherwise, I cannot get the camera in there and you will have no idea where it is. So you need to have the car leveled. If you jack it up, you have to jack it on the back side too, because otherwise if it's too much to the back, you have some coolant in the engine. If you want to drain it really good, it needs to be leveled. But you can go ahead and jack the front end a little bit if you cannot reach underneath. So facing the front left side of the car, okay, this way, let me show you where the drain plug is located. Okay, this white thing right there, this is guys the coolant drain plug. This is the radiator drain plug right there, so we'll need to get that one loose. Okay, so you can reach the drain plug from underneath the car, but since we have the airbox removed, we do it from here. Okay, we turn it. We're going to go ahead and turn it counterclockwise, okay, to get it loose. And coolant will start draining. Okay, you can see, but now, next step, we need to open the radiator cap. And when you open the cap, the coolant will start draining faster. Okay guys, so you can see how it's draining now. Should be that green coolant, you know, the Elantra coolant is extremely dark green. Okay, so we can go ahead and close it now. We drain the whole thing. I would recommend not to touch it with your fingers, always use gloves, because coolant is poisonous. It's not good for your skin as well. You just get it out by hand, make sure you don't use any tools to break it, okay, you can see. And let me show you, okay, how much we got out of it. Okay, just a little bit over a gallon, because we spilled a little bit. So once coolant is drained, we'll proceed by removing the four bolts you can see on the water pump pulley. You have to remove them while you have the belt installed, because now you can actually, the belt will hold the pulley and you'll be able to remove the bolts. Otherwise you will not be able to remove them later, so we'll do that first. We're going to go ahead and use a 10mm offset box wrench for the job, like this one here. Okay, so we can go ahead and remove them now. You can see the last, the ones on the bottom are hard to get to sometimes, but once you get them loose. Okay, perfect. So next, we're going to get the belt loose. We'll need to get the belt loose so we can remove it. And that has a manual tensioner that you have to get loose, and we will show you how to do that now. So we'll need a 14mm socket. We'll need to get that bolt loose. Do not remove it. Perfect. Next, we're going to use a 12mm. There is one bolt on the side of the tensioner there. You just get it loose, about one or two revolutions. Next, on top with the same 12, we'll start getting the bolt loose. And the alternator will start dropping down and the belt will get loose. So we can remove the belt from the water pump pulley now. That's where you remove it first. You slide it out of there to the side. Okay, and can just pull the whole belt out of the way. Now we can spin the pulley and we're going to remove all four bolts on the water pump pulley so we can remove the pulley. Okay, the first bolt is loose, we pulled it out, this is what it looks like. Now we can proceed with the rest of the three bolts and we'll come back. So this is the last bolt. Okay. Let's see if we'll be able to slide the pulley out. Now, you don't have to do that, but we're going to do it to be a little bit easier and be able to show you better. We cannot get the pulley out. Everything is so tight. So what we're going to do, we'll support the engine on the bottom. We'll remove the engine mount and we'll jack this side of the engine up a little bit. That way we'll have more room to reach all the bolts and we'll be able to remove the pulley. Okay, so you can see we have the jack with a wood block. That way we'll not punch a hole in the oil pan. We supported the engine, just pumped it about half an inch up. Next we'll remove the engine mount on top. We have three nuts and one bolt. 17mm socket. You have to be careful for the engine not to drop before you remove the last one, when you remove the last nut. Because if it's not jacked up enough, it will try to drop down. So we'll go ahead and show you how to remove that top engine mount so we can stick the camera and show you better. Okay, it's coming out now. Perfect. Next, one person will go to jack the engine up a little bit. Okay, you cannot go too much, but a little bit will do the work. Okay, like that. So you can see, move the engine a little bit, careful not to drop it. The pulley came out, and this is your water pump right here. We will need 10mm socket or wrench or box, offset box wrench to remove those bolts now. Once we remove it, we'll show you exactly how many bolts and where they are located. There is one on the bottom side of the pulley. Should be only one there. Now we have to be extra cautious, extra careful for the engine not to drop on your hand. So make sure it's securely bolted on the bottom. Use jack stands as well to support it, because there is no engine mount. If it fails, it's going to smash your hand. So this is just the way we do it, doesn't mean that it's the correct way. Last bolt. Now the pump is loose, so nothing should be holding it anymore. Okay, gently, just there should be two glides. Okay, yeah. This is it. So this is the gasket here. It's recommended to replace it every time you install a new pump, so you can see that's how we remove it. So we'll go ahead and install the new pump now. Stay with us to see how we're going to do that now. The links for all the parts, guys, that we use will be listed in the description of the video below. Don't forget to put a new gasket as well, every time. So we will go ahead and install all the bolts now, in the reverse order that we took it apart. So the torque wrench that we are using, you can find the link to it on Amazon, guys, that's where we got it from. Now we need to, you can go anywhere between 9.8 to 11.8 newton meters, or for the small torque wrench like this one, it uses inch per pound, it should be anywhere between 87 and 104 inch pound. Okay, if you use Newton meters, 9.8 to 11.8. So we have ours set at about 100. Maximum is 104, so we will go at 100 on this one. So you see the torque wrench handle will move when it reaches that optimum torque. Okay, so you can see when the handle moves. Okay, like that, this is the optimum torque. You have to be careful not to go too much, because you can still go, so you definitely have to feel when it's done. After that, after this one, we'll go the opposite one. We'll go to this one here. Perfect. Now we'll do one of the top ones. Okay, after that it's hard to get to, but we'll have to do the bottom one before we proceed with the next one. Okay, perfect. Now we have one more, guys, that we need to do, and at the end, stay with us, we'll show you what else we need to do. Okay, just like that. So we'll start, check all of them. Okay, for that click first. Okay, this one is a little bit hard to get to here from the AC line. Almost there. Okay. Okay, this one needed just a little bit more. One here. Perfect. After that, we have this one over there. Excellent. And last one is the one on the bottom. Okay, just like that. So next, we will need to install the pulley, get the bolts tied by hand. After that, you need to install the belt. Okay, and once you install the belt, you can torque down the bolts for the pump just for with the same specs as we did the other bolts. 9.8 to 11.8 Newton meters. And don't forget to put coolant in your car, bleed the cooling system, guys. If you need help with any of that, it will be on the channel. So no need to waste your time from now on. Thank you for watching, guys. Please subscribe and many more videos to come.